Hey guys, I'm Mickey from the Tynker dev team, and I'm here to lead you through a tutorial on how to make a cool game with Tynker. By the end of this tutorial, you'll have a project that looks something like this. There's a bunch of balls that bounce around, and if we click once, it'll create an explosion. And if a ball touches the explosion, it will also create an explosion. The goal of the game is to chain as many explosions together at once. Let's see what we can get. Here looks good. Cool. So here's our workshop for Tynker. We have our code here, we have our actors, and we have our stage. So what we're gonna do, we actually don't need this actor, so we'll delete it for now. And to make the bouncing balls, we'll create a new actor with the drawing tool. And this drawing tool, we can draw whatever we like. But since it's just a ball, we can use the circle tool and draw something like this. Center it. Bam. And we can call this actor ball and save it. We can go back. And there's our actor. If we want to make multiple balls, we can create clones of this main actor. So we can use this onStart block and then use a repeat block. So that we can do it multiple times. We'll do it 20 times, and we can create clone of, create clone of self. Now if we run this, it'll create 20 clones, but they're all hidden behind this block. So what we want to do is have the balls move around and appear in random spots. So we can use the clone startup block. Anytime a clone is created, it'll run the code inside of here. So in this clone startup block, we can use the goTo block in the motion. And we want it to go to a random spot on the screen. So what we can use is the random block inside the operators tab. Pick random, we'll use two of them, one for the X and one for the Y. And now we want to have it so the ball is a random position from the left to the right and up and down. And so inside of sensing, we can scroll down and use screen left, screen right, screen left, screen right, screen bottom, and screen top. So now when we run it, the 20 balls will be all over the screen, and it'll be different each time. The balls are a little big, so what we can use is the size block. So we can set the size to about 30%, and setting it in the main actor will do it in all the clones too. That looks pretty good. Now we want to get the balls to move. Before we get them to move, we can get them to point in a random direction. So in the motion, we can use, point in direction. Right now, it'll point to the right, and if we wanted to point it in a random direction, we can use the random block again. And we'll say from 0 to 360. And then after that, we want the ball to move. So we'll put a forever loop. So it'll do this continuously. And we want it to go to the motion and move. Am I missing it? Right here. We'll have it move 1 pixel. And we'll have it wait just a little bit, 0.05. And so now all the balls will move. It's a little slow, so we'll increase it from 1 pixel to 3 pixels. Still a bit slow, let's try 5. And we can lower the wait time. Here we go, balls are moving fast. But if you see here, all the balls go off screen. We want them to bounce around. Luckily, we have a good block called ifOnEdgeBounce. Now, if the balls touch any side of the screen, they'll bounce. And this will keep them all inside of here. And that's the first step to creating any of the moving balls. The next step is to create the pop explosions. Right now, when we run the game, the balls will bounce around, but there'll be no explosions, and nothing happens when you click. Before we can show an explosion, we should make an actor for the explosion. So we can actually duplicate this last actor and rename it to explosion. And in its code, we'll keep some of it. We don't need to create clones, but we'll create the clone startup. And we'll go back to the ball actor. Right now, after the ball creates 20 clones, we want it to follow our mouse. That way, when we click, it can create an explosion right there. What we're going to use is a repeat block. We're going to use a special one, though. We're going to use repeat until, and we're going to use a mouse down. So everything in this block will happen until a mouse down is found. We will go back to motion and we'll use go to mouse pointer. Now the ball will follow our mouse around, and once we click, it will stop following. Show that again, following, and once I click, it stops following. Now, after we click and it stops following, that's the time to create an explosion. So we can create another clone, but instead of creating one of the self, we can create one of explosion. And inside of explosion, on the clone startup, we can use a repeat block and have that actor grow bigger and bigger and bigger, like an explosion. So right now I'll put repeat 200 and go back to sense looks, go to change size, and we'll change by 1%. So let's try it. Started right away. Oh, I accidentally put create clone inside of here. Let me put it outside. And once I click, there we go. Explosion is created. However, the explosion needs to disappear, and it's not being created where the mouse is. What we're going to do is we're going to create two global variables. One called the X position for all actors, and one called the Y position for all actors. We can set the X and the Y position to be the global variable, to be the current position of this actor. And inside of the explosion, before it explodes, we can actually have it go to that position. So that way, when we click, we say what position it is, and then the explosion will go there, right here. Perfect. Now, the last thing to do is to make the explosion go away after some time. We don't want it to disappear immediately, so we'll use a wait block. We'll have it wait 0.3 seconds, and then after it's done, we'll have it hide. And let me grab a hide block right here. So it'll follow my mouse, and when I click, and then it disappears. You might notice that this is still here and this explosion is still here. What we can do is we can actually hide the original and have the clone show when it starts. And in the ball, after it creates a clone, it should hide itself. So now we don't have any balls that are not moving, and when I click and it disappears, there's nothing there. And that's how you make the explosions. Now that we can create explosions, we're going to work on chaining the explosions. If any of the balls touch an explosion, nothing happens right now, but we're going to change that. Inside of the clone setup, we're going to work in the forever loop. In the forever loop, the ball's moving, it's waiting, and if it touches the edge, it bounces. We're going to add one more thing, an if statement. We're going to have, if the block is touching a clone of the explosion, then it should create an explosion. And we can actually copy these things right here. We can right click, copy, and then right click, paste, put it right in here. Lastly, we should have a show block on startup here. So now when we run, if we click, then it'll chain all the explosions together. Oh, that's a pretty good one. How many can we get? Oh, what is that? Eight left. That's pretty good. We got 12 out of 20. And so now that the the ball's chain explosions, we have the game almost done. We can add a little bit more fun things now, like certain colors, or we can add in a counter to see how many balls you have, or you can change the game in any kind of way that you like. Now that we have the main game working, there's some things that we can add that are pretty cool, like color. All the balls right now are red, and this seems a little bit boring. What we can do is in the ball actor, in the clone, at the beginning, after it goes to a certain location and points in a certain direction, we can actually use change color effect. So the change color effect will actually change the color of the costume. So it'll go from red right now to blue. And now we don't want all the balls to be the same color. So we can actually use the random block again, and we'll say from 0 to 100. And now each ball will be completely different color. There's one issue though. When I click it, all of the explosions will be red. And that's not as fun. So what we can do is we can actually have the explosions be the same color as the balls as well. The way that we can do that, instead of just picking a random, we can actually have a variable. So we can use a script variable right here. So we'll make a new variable and we call this one clone color. And we can set the clone color to random from 0 to 100. And we can have it change by the clone color. So this doesn't affect the properties of the colors just yet. It behaves the same. But now what we can do, the same way that we created an X and Y variable that were global, we can also create a color variable that's global. And what we can do is we can set the color to the clone color. And inside of the explosion actor, we can actually copy an explosion actor. At the clone startup, we can do the same thing. We can go to looks, change color effect by, and it's just like we use the X and Y position here, we can use the color variable. Let's find that color, put it right here. And now the explosions will be the same color as the ball that spawned it. There is one issue. The first one's black. Or was it? It was black. The first one's random. And that's because we haven't set that variable yet. So at the beginning, right here, at the beginning, we can set color to 0. And now it'll always be red. Nice. Once you're done with the project, we have a couple of bonus tasks that you might want to try out. Try adding a counter to see how many explosions you have. Try adding random colors to the explosions as well. Maybe as the explosions grow, they change color. And we might also want to add multiple clicks. So if you click once for the explosion and it's done, you can click again and again to add more explosions. Good luck with your coding, and I hope you enjoyed this project.